वीर्यं करभावहैः तेजस्विनावरीदमस्तु मा विद्विषावहैः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्छते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमाधाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते स्याभवद्भक्तजनातिहन्धुगुपदत्तमन्येषभिचार्यदूर्णं स्तम्भेव धारस्तमनन्यलभ्यं लक्ष्मीनृसिंहं शरणं प्रपद्ये अहो बिले गरुडशैलमध्ये कृपावसात्कल्पितसन्निधानं लक्ष्म्या समालिङ्गितवामभागं लक्ष्मीनृसिंहं शरणं प्रपद्ये शिवरे श्रीलक्ष्मीनृसिंहपरब्रह्मणे नमः अस्मद्गुरुभ्यो नमः अस्मत् सर्वगुरुभ्यो नमः अस्मत् परमगुरुभ्यो नमः केशवार्य कृपापात्रं देशमादिगुणान्नवं श्रीषडार्यदीशानां देशिहेन्द्रमहं भजे प्रपत्ये नरवत्यानां निषध्यां गुणसम्पदां शरणं भवभीतानां षडगोपमुनीश्वरं श्रीरङ्गनाथषडगोपरिन्ददृष्टं लक्ष्मीनृसिंहषडजित्करुणैकपात्रं श्रीरङ्गवीररघुनाथषडगोपकृत्यं वेदान्तदेशीयदीन्द्रमहं प्रपत्ये श्रीमते शिवन्षडगोप श्रीवेदान्तदेशीयदीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः श्रीमद्रङ्गषडारिसंयुराद् लब्धागमान्धत्वयं श्रीमद्वीररघुत्तहात्यषडजित् पाधारविन्दाश्रयम् श्रीमद्वेदवदं सदेशिगरे कारुण्यवीक्षास्पदं सेवे रङ्गदुरीनशासनवसं नारायणं योगिनं श्रीमते श्रीलक्ष्मीनरसिंहदिव्यपादुकासेवकम् श्रीमन् षडगोप श्रीनारायणैरीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः वेदान्तदेशीरीन्द्रकटाक्षलप्त त्रयन्तसारमणवत्यगुणम्बुदग्र्यं नारायणात्यतितुल्यकृपाभिषिक्तं श्रीरङ्गनाथैरिशेखरमाश्रयामः श्रीमते शिवन् षडगोप श्रीरङ्गनाथैरीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः यो नित्यमच्युतपदाम्बुजग्मरुग्म व्यामोहदस्तरिधराणि तृणाय मेने अस्मद्गुरोर्भगवतोऽसिधैकसिन्धोः रामानुजस्य शरणौ शरणं प्रपद्ये श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्य कविधार्किकेसरि वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि ज्ञानानन्दमयं देवं निर्मलस्फटिकाकृतिम् आधारं सर्वविद्यानां हयग्रीवमुपास्महे गुरुभ्यः तद्गुरुभ्यश्च नमो वाहमधीमहे वृणीमहे च दद्राद्यौ दम्पती जगदाम्बदी प्रायप्रबदने पुंसां पौनःपुण्यं निवारयन् हस्तश्रीरङ्गभर्तूत्माम् अव्याधभयमुद्रितः अखिलभुवनजन्मस्तेम भङ्गादिलीले विनदविविधभूदौरातरक्षैकदीक्षे श्रुतिशिरसि विदीप्ते ब्रह्मणे श्रीनिवासे भवतु मम परस्मिन् सेमुषी भक्तिरूपा पाराचर्यवचःसुधाम् उपनिषत् दुःखाप्तिमध्योद्धृधां संसाराग्निविदीपनव्यपगत प्राणार्थसञ्जीवनीं पूर्वाचार्यसुरक्षिधां बहुमती व्याघाददूरस्थितां आनीतां तु निजाक्षरैः सुमनसः भौमाभिवन् त्वन्वहम् So this is second class in the Sribhashyam. Unlike others, we have the open book. Everybody has got the notes in front of them. We'll follow one by one. So I just want to say a couple of things. We will try to cover what we covered in the last class and we'll go very fast. This is very similar to Nambalai when he was giving the Thiruvayumuri in Srirangam. It's called Idu. Nambalai Idu 36,000 padi. When he was giving, there are some people who were there sitting. The first 2 days, they were listening. After 2 days, in those days, they don't have that many vehicles or anything. So some more people have come. And they said, oh, Swami, we come very late. We want to join this one. So then he says, okay, I'll start all over again. So Pravesam, Dudiya Pravesam, and then something called Mahapravesam. Then he says, this is it. If you come late, we will start. So in that way, we will go back and start. Whatever we had done. Every time I keep on updating the notes here and there. So it depends on the questions what it comes, I keep on elaborating that one. But whatever we do that one, I want to say a couple of things. We do Gajendra Moksham, we do Uddhava Gidei, we do Abhay Pradhana Saram, Ramayanam, so many things. Uddhava Gidei and Ramayanam, if you take that one, most of them are audience creative views. So it gives a lot of flexibility because no Purvacharyas have done that much into that. So it's a free road. So we can go and do all the interpretation and all of them. When you come to Gajendra Moksham and everything, there are certain words. I cannot do whatever I want, but we can be more creative of breaking the padams and try to say all of them. So there also we can tell some more. But when you come to Sribhashyam and Ragasyatra Saram and Thirupavai, not much. Already they paved the way. There are three lanes are there. Either you go left in the middle or the right. That's all it is. So here what we're going to do, if you hear Sribhashyam from Tenacharya Sampradayam or from Andavana Ashramam or Madam, each one will be a little different because they take their own kind of things important. So we will add here, whether you add a Thiruvayamuri, whether you add Desigan into that. See, when you explain Sribhashyam, exactly literally you take it, there is no Desigan at that period. But so we add all of them, so that makes it more creative. Whether you add a Alvar's Pasuram, whether you add a Desigan's Pasuram or a Desiganude Slogam or any other thing, that's how it makes. So Thirupavai you hear from so many people, but each one tells it different. Everybody tells the same thing. The central core is the same, but they try to give it a different flavor. So that is how this would be. That is the reason why we try to put the notes so that you keep the notes in front of you and then we can go through one by one. So let me pick the notes here. So this is Sribhashyam, what we are going to see. Everybody knows it's written by Bhagavat Ramanuja and we are getting the 1000th year in a couple of years. So he's the avataram of Adisesham. Everybody knows that one. So at the end of his life, this is where we picked up in Ragasyatra Saram. In the Ragasyatra Saram, Imbhirmanar at the end of his life, 125 years, he was saying, okay, the purpose for me to come on this is finished. I want to go back. All great acharyas, they can decide when they want to go. So he decided to go. Immediately all the sishyas next to him says, oh, we cannot live without you. You are such a great acharya. There is no purpose for us to live anymore. So we want to kill ourselves. Then Ramanuja was laughing at them. You don't have no power to kill yourself. What do you want? The Atma Yatrai Bhagavanukku Adheenamanathu. Deha Yatrai Karma Bandhathil Irukkakoodiyathu. So very simply he said, two words. That is what Swami Desigan picks it so beautifully and says, Nissamsayaka Sugamashwa. When we said that one, Nissamsayaka. Why Nissamsayaka? Because when you say the Atma, definitely Bhagavan will give you moksham. This is the Mahavishwasam. It doesn't matter whatever you do. I say the Acharya, but I have learnt everything on this. MSR Swami, what he used to say, even they do Bhagavata Bacharam, Bhagavata Bacharam, such a difficult one. He couldn't even say that one. Asakhya Bacharam. For that, sometimes Bhagavan may delay the moksham. Abdinu Soldra. That is what he says. He doesn't even say, nowhere it says, Bhagavan once guaranteed a moksham for you, he will take it back. Tan nadiyal tiraktagattu tamarayalagilum sidagurekkume. Ennadiyar adiseyyar. Periyarvar says so beautifully. And Thayar recommends to Bhagavan, Purushagaratvam, why don't they give moksham for him? He comes back here and he says from today onwards he is going to be good and everything. So let's give the moksham. Bhagavan says, okay, you told me, I'm going to give the moksham. And then later on she wants to test whether the Bhagavan is really like that or not. Because he is one gunam. Bhagavan has got the highest one from Desiya Sampradayam, you know. One gunam, one character Bhagavan has got ultimately is Swatantriyam. Same thing, one quality Pirati has got, which Bhagavan does not have, is Purushavaratva. One recommends, one signs. That's all. Other than that, in Desiya Sampradayam, both of them are equal. They can do anything. all of them like taking a coin, head and tail, mari midunam. And the midunam you have to remember when we go through the Sribhashyam and Ragasyatra Saram. So, Tannadiyar Tirathagatte Thamarayal Agilum. So, Thayar goes and tells, I told you on that day to give moksham. I didn't know. I thought this is the only accounting book. Now I see there are hundreds of accounting book. All these liabilities and assets, I look. Assets are so small, liabilities are so huge. Please cancel the moksham for him. That is what you said. Bhagavan gets really mad and he says, Ennadiyar adi seyyar. Hey Lakshmi, maybe your devotee may be like that. My devotee, when he says he is going to do Sharanagati and he wants for that one, definitely I am going to give. And whatever he does. So, Pradyodhyabhingar Vandangaracharya, when he explains this one, he separates differently. Ennadi, yar seyyar. So, he shows his power, swadendriyam. So, that's what Bhagavan is. Why Periyadavar says like that? Because for Periyadavar, Perumal is the Mapulai, Jamada. So, he always, more than my daughter, Bhagavan is higher. That is the way. Because we usually say Thayar is more Karunyam than Bhagavan. And here he shows Bhagavan is more than the Thayar. So, what we have to understand, once he has given the moksham, it is written for you, definitely you will get it. There is no qualms on that one. So, Nissam Sayaka. That is, Dehayatrai Bhagavan Kadinamanadi. Bhagavan Kadinamanadi. So, you have the boarding pass sitting on the lounge, and when the plane is going to depart, you don't have it. When they say announce it, then you have to go. Similarly, that is what it is. And then, Dehayatrai, that is Atmayatrai. Atmayatrai Bhagavan Kadinamanadi. Dehayatrai Karmadhinamanadi. Depends on whatever. What karma is going we are talking? What karma? Prarabdha karma. What are you going to do in this janma? What you are? In this janma will naan anubhavippadaga uttu kollapatta karma. Abhyugada prarabdha karma. Very good, very good. So, abhyugada prarabdha karma is, this is in this janma what we have agreed to go through. So, and abhyugada prarabdha karma, whatever he has opened, we have to go. And Bhagavan may reduce it without knowing ourselves. Still, he cannot eliminate that. You have to understand. So, I am become so close to you. I am so befriend and everything. It's just like Obama says, I got elected. I am a president-elect. We are all president-elect. We are not ordinary citizen. You have to behave like a president. But for that matter, you cannot go to the White House and claim that. Because, hey, wait, until January, you cannot come here. So, you are elected in November. And until January 22nd or whatever that date, you have to wait. And that is what we are in. So we are not in the town with the people. We are not in the people in the plane. We are having the boarding pass and walking around. Trisangu Shurgam. That is what we are all Prabhannas. So in the Trisangu Shurgam, how long I have to wait? Depends on whatever the pavam you have done. So when the plane is going to leave in half an hour or 1 hour or probably tomorrow morning, you have to lie down there. There's nothing you can do. So, same thing here. So, Dehayatrai Karmadhinamana. So, Embarumana is asking, your Atma belongs to Bhagavan, your body belongs to, when it's going to die, it depends on whatever the karma you did. So, in between, what power you have? What you have? Remember I told, in the Bodhi classes I told in the Uddhava Gita, when we talked about Pingala, very nice in Uddhava Gita, very hot to see, the advice from a prostitute. And Shuga Brahmam has taken that one to show that one. In that one, the Avadhuda was telling, Avadhuda is the Dattatreya. He's telling very nicely, once when you have aham, if you define an aham, then mama will come. If you don't define correctly, then mama would really kill you. Aham, when I say, idu ennudaiya car, sir. When you say, this is my car, what do you say, this is my car? Because I paid, I bought, I paid and I got the title. So when you say I, that means you are talking about you. That is what you call this. Let us assume, it is Perumal Kone, sir. This is the Perumal's house. Then you don't say, this title is for me. See, that is why. If you kill Aham, then Mama immediately would be gone. That is what Avadhudan beautifully explaining on that one. Similarly, if you have, without killing Aham, you cannot have the Mamagaram, will not die. without having a vairagyam, your dehabandham will not go. So, even though there is a abhyogada prarabdha karma you had to go through, the easy way to escape of that one is to get the vairagyam. That is what Avadhuta was explaining on the Pingala. Same thing we told there in the Gajendra Moksham also, that one. So what I'm trying to say, anywhere you go, same thing will be. It is just like the cooking. Parupu, whatever you have, vegetable, whether you make a karamedu or a koot or avial, all of them very, very similar, different types. Basic ingredients are same. So what you learnt in Sri Ragasya Trasaram, that will go everywhere. Because Ragasthetranam is like a funnel at the end, it catches. Whether it's Sri Bhashyam or Thiruvayamuri Saram or Gita Bhashyam, the what do we call a Grandha Sudushtayam, all of them Ragasthetra Saram will carry. So when Embarumanar was saying like that one, then all the Sishyas were saying that's okay. So Embarumanar has already commanded, we cannot kill ourselves. And Embarumanar so beautifully says, this is the my command, I'm saying you cannot kill on Alavandar's Thiruvadi. My Acharya's Thiruvadi, I'm telling, you don't have no right to kill yourself. That's what he said. So everybody was quiet down. Then he says, how are we going to spend the time? Just like Uddhava is asking Krishna, I cannot live without you. So Krishna gives advice. Same thing, Ramanujar gives advice to all these people. So when he gives advice, there are five of them. At that day, I just mentioned one, people were asking, what's the other four? So I put it down there. So study Sri Bhashyam and propagate. Sri Bhashyatai padithi pravarpital. Adarku argadai illavidil yogyadai. That's what he calls. Adarku yogyadai illavidil nalaira divya pravanna. Alvar arulichayal, arulichayal. So you do the divya prabandham. And if you are not eligible for that, do the kaingaryam in the temple. Kaingaryam in the temple, the most sacred kaingaryam in the temple is sweeping the floors. Sweeping the floors, okay. Yeah. So that is what Ragasatrasar, all this Ragasatrasaram teaches. So sweeping the floor and washing the dishes, which you think is lowest thing in the temple, what you want to do, that is the highest kaingaryam, you're saying. So the third one is a kaingaryam, or not necessarily all of them, mala todukkardu, poo todukkardu, sathabadi, amudubadi, all those things, perumalukku vastram sathardu, all anything you can do. Just like some right now, we have a beautiful sahasradhara plate. So they made that one and we're going to give it to the temple. So any kaingaryam we do. The next one is, just sit down, then recite the Dvaya Mantra. How do you recite the Dvaya Mantra? Arthanusandhanena. Okay, everybody got that one. So you have to know, Sri, Mati, Narayana, Charanau, Sharanam, Prabhat, Yay, remember that one, that is Desi Sampradayam. Srimade Narayana, Aya Namaha. What is Yay says? No. Aginchanyam. Prabhat A means Prabhat A says Karpanyam. Karpanyam says, I cannot do anything. I'm such a low level. The destitute. Kannara aridhi perumalda poi solrom. Edukkume argade illadavan naan. Abdine. Adhaan. So, when you Uttam Purusha Ega Vachanam, that is what Desian calls. Uttama Purusha Ega Vachanam. He's a Uttama Purushan. Why? Because he accepts. Everybody else pretends they know. But he says, Bhagavan, I don't have anything. Bhagavan says, come first. You are the most eligible person. So, Sri, Mati, Narayana, Charanau, Sharanam, Prabhat, seven of them in the Ubhayam. Siddhobayam, Sadhyobayam. What is the Siddhobayam and the Sadhyobayam? Siddhobayam is? Sriman Narayana Charanau. Existing means. Sharanam Prabhatye is executable means. Remember this one? This is what the Sri Bhashyam is going to be. First two chapters and second two chapters going to be. Okay? And the second part, Uttarakhandam is? Kaingaryam. Uttarakhandam is the Palan. Mokshatala pona anandam. Why you are doing Sharanagadi? Are you doing Sharanagadi for the anandam? Kaingaryam. So anandam is a byproduct. That's it. See, these are the basic things. If you know, then we can go through Sri Bhashyam very nicely. This is what Desigan has given for us to understand some of the preliminary things. So if you're not eligible any of those things, then he comes here, says, you live under the shadow of a Sri Vaishnava. That is the Bhagavad Kaingarya. Bhagavad Kaingarya means Bhagavad Kaingarya Tunode Uccham. Okay. End of that one. Okay. So Anude Kashtai, that's what they call. Bhagavad Kaingarya Kashtai, Bhagavad. Bhagavad Kaingarya. இருக்கலாம், அதாவது சில பேருக்கு வந்து வாயால சொல்லறதுக்கு வாய் கோணி போயிருக்கலாம், பேச முடியாம இருக்கலாம், அதாவது மைண்ட் சில சமயத்துல தான் இருக்கும், சில சமயத்துல இருக்காது. சோ மெனி டிஃபரெண்ட் திங்ஸ் ஆர் தேர். சோ தட் இஸ் வை ஹி வாஸ் வெரி வெரி கேர்ஃபுல் அண்ட் சேயிங், if you stay next to a good Sri Vaishnavan, adiru mostly deshiyandla sollacha prabannan, stay with the people who are going to board the same plane with you, don't go out of the lounge. So when you stay in that lounge, what happens is, avata solran sir ingan thooyitana konja elbunga sir, so you say I may fall asleep, please wake me up. So they wake you up when the plane comes. So that is the reason we calibrate ourselves looking at each other. So never leave that goshti. Paragala Madhati Swami told the same thing. Okay? So when Jodi has asked all of them, so he was telling the same thing. Mm-hmm. Never leave the goshti. Mm-hmm. Don't do anything to harm the goshti. Mm-hmm. Stay with them. Mm-hmm. Stay with them. Mm-hmm. That is what he says. Mm-hmm. That is the most important. So you have to be with the Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavan is very, very easy. Bhagavad Gita is very tough. The problem is, Bhagavan is always sattvagunam. Bhagavad Gita are not. And you have to have that kind of a mindset to bear that one. Adhika mele vatsalyam. Bhagavan solra mari, arisile kallu poduthu pola, if they cook everything with the stone, oh, bhogyama iruka. When you say like that one, you are the true Prabhanna. That is why, see, Desigan says, Prabhati, if you do moksham is easy, don't go through the Bhakti Margam. We signed all of them. Now we read the small letters at the bottom. When you read the bottom at that, Bhagavad Avacharam is very, very, very severe. So you have to be very careful. Not an ordinary Bhagavad Avacharam, many people ask. Not just like two vadais for Suresh and one vadai for Srikantana. Those kinds of things, it's not. Asakhyabacharam. See, when the abacharam is the one, when they do, first, knowingly do, second, repeatedly do, third, after that one you say, what's wrong with that? When you say that one, that is a problem comes up. So this is where people make mistakes. So many things we have seen. We've seen Agalya Sabavimochanam. We said that Bali and even Sita, we took that one. Mandodari, Sita, Tara, Ella. So, but there's nobody who's infallible. Everybody makes mistakes. We should not be afraid of that. But what it says, Desigan, that will not remove your moksha. Don't worry about that. But you have to correct yourself. So, Swami, you're going in the wrong expressway. No, I know. Instead of going east, if it keeps on going west, you'll never get there. So at some point we have to correct and do. That is what Desigan says, that one. Even Prabhati also, why many people don't do Prabhati na? The first reason is you don't accept that we are wrong. If you have so much ego, there's nothing you can do. You haven't still got the Madhusudanan Kadaksham. So Nirhyadiga Kribe may be there, Yadarchika Punya may be there, and the third step is the Madhusudana Kadaksham is not there. Everything coming from the Ragasatra Saram. Okay? So, coming back. So, the rest of them are very easy when you can go through. Following the commands all our Acharyas are telling. And Sri Bhashyam is so complex. I don't think nobody can explain. That is what Sudaprakashika said. Sudaprakashika Acharya is such an amazing. Deshika took most of his views, everything from him. Such a noble person, such a wizard. And he says, I don't think nobody can explain Sri Bhashyam. It is so complex, only Embarumanar can do that. If is a divine grace is there, we can scratch the surface. And that is what we are trying to do. We are not attempting anything like a kalakshepam. We are not attempting anything like an upanyasam. This is a very high level lecture only. There is nothing you have to do. Desigan said after prabhati, there's nothing you have to do as a ubhayam for moksha. Okay? As a palan, moksha palan, we are enjoying here reading the Sribhashyam, doing the Kaingarya. That is all we are doing. So this is sadhya bhakti. It's not sadhana bhakti. Sadhana bhakti is the one, that's what we're going to talk in whole Sribhashyam. When we talk about, remember, sadhana bhakti means it is a vehicle, it is a means through which we want to get something. So there are rishis who want to do bhakti yogam and everything, try to go to moksham. We are not looking for that. Mundalu mariya dhanil moyile venda, munna madil ase dhanai vidugai thinnam. வேண்டாது சரண நெறி வேறோர் கூட்டு வெண்டிலயன் நத்திரன் போல் வெள்கி நிற்கும். நெவர் பிரபத்தி சே ஹே லீவ் மீ அலோன், ஐ டோன்ட் வாண்ட் டு பி டச்ட். பிரபத்தி இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் சிங்கிள் மீன்ஸ். வென் யூ பிரிங் எனி திங் எல்ஸ் தென் அதுக்கு பார்க்கலாம். ஐ டோல்ட் ஐ கிவ் யூ ஆல் தீஸ் திங்ஸ், யூ டோன்ட் பிலீவ் திஸ் பிரம்மாஸ்திரம் அண்ட் யூ ஸ்டார்ட் புட்டிங் திஸ் ஜூட் த்ரெட் ஆஞ்சநேயர் பண்ணார். So you're trying to put the sanal kayar vechi kattinane brahmastram nandugo adhe mari prabhati velgi nirkum, it will become so shy. I can give all these things, is going to such a cheap one avrinto. So anala, you don't have to do any of those things. What we are doing in Sribhashyam, you have to understand, it is a bhakti yogatle kuttu go to moksham. But we have done prabhati. What we are learning this one is an anubhavam. This is a sadhya bhakti for us, not a sadhana bhakti. We don't have to do any more means. Once you are done, that is it. Vendadu sharana neri veror kuttu vendil, if you do, ayan athiram bol brahmastram velgi nirkum, it will be shy and move away. Okay. So let's move. Pramanam prameyam pramada, ever we are hit on this so many times. Okay, here only I just want to emphasize a thing. We have only three pramanams in Visishtadvaita Siddhanta. Others have so many different things. There's a whole chart is there. So I don't want to confuse. That's why I just stopped over here. Only three. So, you know, Pratyaksham, Anumanam, Shabdam. Of all these three, Shabdam, verbal testimony, which is the Vedas, and all other Shastras is the highest pramanam. That is the Supreme Court. And then Prasthana Traya. So I ask the question, why these three are very important? Ask. I don't know. If you really look at that one, Upanishads, which is the Shruti Sirase Vidipte Brahmani Srinivase, we say in the Mangala. So when we do Sribhashyam, what we are going to do, very, very few instances we will take the source code, what Emperuman has said. Many of them, we are not even eligible to touch any of them. And to tell publicly and to interpret that one. But here and there to show, quote unquote, just like Emperumana took three or four slokams from the Stotraratnam, he put it exactly. And he says, I cannot do anything better than that. The best way to copy them, exactly put it. So just to show how beautifully Emperumana defines this one, we show that. That's all it is. Not the whole thing. May we will do the first page and we'll do the last page fully, so to understand how he brings that one. So Prasthanatraya, Upanishad, Bhagavad Gita and Brahma Sutra. And everybody knows Upanishad is the Veda Siras and everything, and Bhagavad Gita, Krishna gave that one, and Brahma Sutra is the Vyasa Bhagavan has done that. So let me bring the, he had a question yesterday saying that one, when Bhagavan was there, like Adivan Shadagova, first when he got his sannyasam, then he was so confused. He asked Perumal, which Perumal I'm going to worship? Immediately the Malolan was taken and given to him. So he had that one. And then at that time, Desigan pratyaksham for him. And Desigan was giving him, okay, what do you want to ask? I can answer you. அப்போ ஆதிவன் சரகோபன் ஆஸ்க்டு த்ரீ க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் தே சே. தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் ஹி வாஸ் ஆஸ்கிங், இஃப் பகவான் வாஸ் தேர் டெல்லிங் யூ அண்ட் இஃப் தி சாஸ்திரா வாஸ் ஹியர், Which is more important?
Bhagavan.
Bhagavan is important. Okay? So, Vijay had that question yesterday, I accept. But Bhagavan told Gita, but Shastram is Vedas, but you said Vedas are more important than Bhagavad Gita. Very good question. Very good.
Bhagavan is the Veda Garbhan. Veda is also coming from Bhagavan, right?
Vedam, there is no source. This is from Bhagavan's mouth. The reason why it is to explain that one is, when Bhagavan broadcast any mechanism, that is for good people and bad people, interested people, not interested people, it is like Desiyan says, Arasi puri eduthu erula vaari erinja, nobody will get anything. At the end of Ragasatra Saram, that's what it says. Krishna, that's what you did. That is why nobody listened to you. So you have to have the audience. That is why this Kalakshepam and all the Sribhashyam and Ragasatra Saram, they don't tell to anybody. You have to come and ask the Acharya. In those days, you have to be eligible. You have to make yourself eligible to listen. Otherwise, they don't. Because that is why it is called Ragasyam. So, Krishna openly gave all of them. So, it is not a one-to-one mechanism. When Adivansha Raghavan, to him, Desiyan came and he was talking. For example, Mukur Ayage singer, until 90 years old, he was in Mukur, in his own village. And then suddenly one day he came to the Srirangam. Why? In the Swapanam Purumal came, hey, you are going and building the temple, Goburam. He was telling, I am a sannyasi, I am a vayodhigan. Ranganatha, I am older than you. He was saying, 91 years old, you are asking me to go there. But Purumal commanded, I cannot say anything. I had to go. So there Purumal directly talks to you. Same thing like Embirmanar, when he goes and takes the bath in the river, he goes with his cousin who's a Brahmin. When he comes out, he comes with a fourth Varna holding him coming. How is it possible? No. Bhagavan talks to him. We don't know. So that is why many places, I shouldn't say many places, Desiyan quotes very subtle saying, when you look at the acharam of a great Mahans, there may be certain deviations are there. Don't go by that. You don't know what it is. So carefully you have to handle. So you may go to that Acharyan, you want to learn Sribhashyam. And that Acharyan may get up at 8 o'clock. And when you go and see him, he might not have even brushed his teeth. We don't know why it is. This Acharyan is not like that. Don't start complaining. Okay? That is what Desiyan says. There are so many things that will apparently confuse you. And other than our Acharyas, my Acharya says, those are all tests for you. Those are all the tests for you so that you have to overcome all of them. So anything apparently it looks like that, don't take it. Ignore. This is one of them Babu's father also taught. Many times he has told. So when you go on the expressway, you might have missed a small loop. He may come back. Don't concentrate on the loop. He's not going to be there. It's a long one going from here to California. 2 minutes he got a bifurcation. Don't look at that. Okay. So here coming back, Upanishad, Bhagavad Gita, Brahma Sura.
Three questions.
One question. I don't know what to do. We'll come back to that one. Yeah. So three questions Desi was said. Yeah, we'll come into that one. Sruti, Smriti, Idhika, because that's Agobal Mana. Kuratarvan says, without any dosham, you cannot find it. Nirdosham. So everything is Vedas, revelations. That's what all the foreign people call. So this is called revelations. Ved Nigamam, Amnayam, Marai, Vaimuri. That is why it's called Thiruvaimuri. And Anadi, Ananta, Apurusheya, Nitya, Nirdosha, everybody knows all of them. So the sad thing is, 1129 shakas are there in Veda, out of which 1000 of them is Samaveda. And we got probably a handful of them only now. Many of them are lost. And many people say it is, all it is last between the period of Ramanuja and today. That is where we lost. Most of them we lost. Just like Desiyan's Vyakhyanaman Thiruvaimoli, Nigama Parimalam. 74,000 padi, not 36,000. 74,000 padi, it is last in the last 300 years. Okay, so the height of these Vedas is the Shruti. Upanishad is the Siras, crown. So Upanishad, that's what it says. Upa means self-knowledge, Nishchaya Jnanam, and the destroyer of the samsara. Okay, so you need the knowledge so that it is a definite and to remove the samsara. That is a one way of breaking. See, whenever you look at many of these things, even the Samskrita Padam and many of these things, several meanings are there. That's not only one of them. We just take it whatever is convenient in that context. That's all. 14 Upanishads out of 108 we are interested. Why? Because under 14, many, many references coming in Sri Bhashya. That is why this. And Rig Veda, if you know, Yajurveda is a large one. So many different Upanishads are coming. And then Sama, and then the Atharvana. Aitreya, Kaushidiki. So that is very important Upanishad. That is where we are going to talk about Archiradi Margam. Dagasatra Saram, we talked about that one. Ishobanit, Kadobanishad, Taittira Upanishad. Taittira Upanishad, that is where when we do the Thirumanjanam for Perumal, we'll be telling Sikshavalli, Anandavalli, and Bhrguvalli, and everything. And then Shedaswara Upanishad, Maitrayini, Mahanarayana Upanishad, we tell that one also. So the next one is Chandogya Upanishad. That is what's more important for us, where the famous word Tattvamasi Vyakhyanam is coming. And Prasna, Mundaka Upanishad, Mandukya Upanishad, all those things. Tavala, Mandukya Upanishad means frog. Smriti is written by the rishis. That is the interpretation of the Vedas. So it takes only the second step. Because when you interpret something, all your handicaps gets in there. So you may be biased, you may not know something. So all those things comes into that one. Itihasa, Ramayana and Mahabharata. Vedas are divided, you know. Shaddarsana, we saw on the last class, the same thing. So we come into the, at the end of that 825, if you go to the, keep on moving, Purva Mimamsa and Uttara Mimamsa. That is where we are talking. Mimamsa means deep research. We try to do, understand correctly, critical investigation. Purva Mimamsa, first told by Jaimini. Basically, it is all the rituals and aradhana about the Perumal. And you do, not only Perumal, when you say Perumal here, everybody is included, all the God. So Vedas, that is why it's a huge problem. They talk so many things. So that is why we don't know what is correct. That is why Samanvadhyayam, Samanvayam, harmony, all of them goes and ends in Narayana. That's what the first adhyayam of the Brahma Sutra we will be talking. First 12 is by Jaimini Karmaganda. Next 4 is Kasakrasta Devadaganda. And both the Jaimini and Kasakrasta are the Sishya of the Vyasa Bhagavan. So we move all those things. We know, we have to know. Okay, one of them. Oh. Sadhana Sadushtayam. I don't know, I mentioned this one before in other places. In Uddhava Gita, Pingala, overnight she got Sadhana Sadushtayam. Sadhana Sadushtayam means, if you want to go to moksham, there are 4 things it has to be rammed in you several times. First one is Nitya Anitya Vastu Vivekam. What is permanent, what is temporary? If you don't know what is permanent and temporary, you'll always will be temporary and again will be asking. That is what is samsara. Permanent is a nitya vibhuti. You cross the Viraja river, anavritti saptad, anavritti saptad, najapunaravartade, najapunaravartade, angubonavan thirumbuvadillai, angubonavan thirumbuvadillai. So when you go there, you'll never come back again. That is what we want. That is permanent. So first understand that one. Second one, ivamuttara palaboga viragaha. That means, if everything is so bogiam here, eating the jalebi and puliyodare and sitting in a AC room, then he is not going to be interested. Sir, why you are not trying for another job now? I'm very happy with this job. Why should I try? So don't rock the boat. So unless you feel, oh, this samsaram is like hell, like what these people say. You have to feel that this is like a Naragamari. I don't want that. I don't want to be born anymore. Irul Tarumanyalatil Ini Piravi Anvende Namalvar says, Irul Tarumanyalam. This Bhulogam, this Pragrithi Mandalam always gives you ignorance. I want to get out of that. So that second one. So you don't like it. It's like a tumultuous situation. Oh, when can I get out of this? The third one, Samadamadi Sadhana Sambattukal. Samam and Dhamam. Samam is your mind. Dhamam is external indriyams. 10 plus 1, 11 indriyams are there. So, Samam and Dhamam, you have to be calm. In Pingala's story, what happened? So, to give you in a nutshell, this girl Pingala is a prostitute. She waits outside. She takes only the rich customers and she enjoys. She gets the money. She enjoys all of them. So, one day she waited and waited and waited. Nobody came. Suddenly her face became very pale and everything. What is this? Why I have to live like this one? So she said, I going inside and outside and all of them. Finally she says, let me go and sit there. She goes after the midnight, sits inside. Bhagavan blessed her. She start thinking, there is no point in doing. Even if I make money today, tomorrow is the same thing. There has to be something permanent. There has to be some vidudali. There has to be some liberation from all of them. Bhagavan blessed that one. She didn't like that job and she was looking for a permanent one and she was sitting calmly and thinking inside. Then she wanted to go for the mumukshutvam. Mm-hmm. Happened overnight for her. Not everybody. It is blessing. So what I want to point out here, we will talk about a little bit before when we go into the first Brahma Sutram, Adado Brahma Jigyasa, Adado Brahma Jigyasa, when we do that one, and Embarumanar has written, Purvapaksham, Lagu Purvapaksham, Lagu Siddhantam, small treatise. There is a refuting Shankara. Shankara was saying, we have karma, jnana. If you want to go to moksha, why don't you go to jnana? Why you have to waste our time? Okay? So to go to the jnanam, you need all these four. These all four, like Nitya Nitya Vastu Vivegam, Yamutra Palaboga Viraga, Samadamadi Sadhana Sambattukal, Mumukshutvam. You should be interested in moksha. Unless Desian says very clearly in Ragasatrasaram, the only qualification you need to go to moksha is you should be interested. Even people are not interested, they get moksha. Like small kids. Okay? Elephant in the temple. Cow. Maybe they are interested. We didn't realize. Maybe they are interested, but they are not saying. They might have done everything. This is the last janma, small piece, Bhagavan says. You'll be born in this family and you'll come there. So, all these four, Shankara said, you have to ram your thing, get ready all of them, then only you'll come to Jnanagandham. If you have all of them, that's why you become a sannyasi. You come out of all of them, you get moksham. But Ramanuja says, no, it is not like that. You cannot make that one as a prerequisite. These are the things we have to go through our life. We get married. You're so happy with the wife. After 30 years, wife or the husband fights with them. Oh, you're waking me in the middle of the night. I'm also having a headache. Why don't you go and take your own water? She'll say the same thing. Ilya, but what happened the day you got married? So you have to know what. Whatever, and now I'm not saying anything, even our own hands and legs, you know, Sri Kanchivaram Sridhartha Tachar, I listened to him so many of them. He used to say, when the small guy is biting all the murukku in Sri Jayanti, hey, you biting the murukku, how many murukkus I would have eaten? You'd be sitting and telling, because no teeth, you know. So similarly, like that one, many of the things what you enjoy, it is not anymore. Then only you realize. Then you think this way. Oh, yesterday I went for one exam and then another exam. One kid has got a problem. Next kid has a problem. The kid got married. They want a grandkid. Keep on going. Never ends. Samsaram is like the tides are coming. Waves are coming in the samudram. So you say, I'm not interested. So that has to come only when you are in grahasthasam. You have to go and keep on hitting. Not as a prerequisite. Then you say, there is a Brahmam. Brahmam is Anandam. Ananda Rubamana Brahmam. Your Jeevan is a Jnana Rubam. When you go there, you will enjoy that one. The enjoyment is basically doing Kaingaryam for him. Oh, that Brahmam, I want to know about him. I want to know about him. How to go there? That is what Jigyasa. That is what is called Ubhayam. That is what called Palan. So we will tell it. But if you put them as a prerequisite, nobody will be coming. So it has to go and hit. That is what Purvapakshami will be explaining. So what I'm trying to say here, in our sampradayam, when you see our acharyas, they are all grahasthasrama. In Shankara, in all these Advaitis, when they do, it is Naishtika Brahmachari. They never get married, they take sannyasam like that. Each one has got a different view. We follow Ramanuja Siddhantam, that's why we do like that, okay? Then when you talk about a Brahma Sutra, which is written for the explanation for the Upanishads. Not only Vedas are confusing, it talks about Indra, Vayu, Varunan and do all these things. If you do this Omam, you get this. If you do this Omam, you get this. Then we are asking, if you take this plastic, go to this shop, go to this shop, go to this shop. Then he is asking, who is paying the bill for this plastic? That is what we are asking. So that is the Brahma Kandam Upanishad. That is what is explaining this Brahma Sutra. Vidyasthanam, 14 of them it says, Angani, Vedas, Chatvaro, Mimamsa, Nyaya Vistaraha, Puranam, Dharma Sastram, Cha, Vidya Herese, Chadudasa. 14 of them. 4 Vedas, 6 Angas, Purana, Nyaya Sastra, Mimamsa, Dharma Sastra. All of them adding 14. Remember this 14? We'll come back to the same 14 in Bhagavad Vishayam, in Tamil. Nammalvar 4 Prabandham, 6 Prabandham for Tirumangai Alvars, and the rest of the 4 is from other Alvars and everything. Veda Sadushtaya, Ango Bangangal Pole, Padinalam, Ippanabal, Achari Hridayam. So we'll be talking over there. So very similar, whether you take a Samskrita Vedam or Dravida Vedam. You see the in parallels on that. Smriti and Itihasa Puranam. So yeah, we go to the next one. Visitta Advaita Siddhantam. That is what we are interested in. Unambiguously we say, Narayana is the Brahmam. Foremost God. There's nothing else is there. Second one. How do we understand he is the Brahmam? Because he is the Jagat Karanagan. So when you say cause, sustenance and dissolution, everything comes into that. Jagat Vyabharam, that is what it's called. And then is the first preceptor, Adi Guru, Gurubhyaha, Tad Gurubhyascha, Namo Vagam, Adimahe, Vrinimagecha, Tadradyav, Dampadi, Jagadampadi. That's what's said. We all the time in Sangalpam we say, our Guru, our Guru, our Guru, unbroken chain. Remember that one, what Deshika says in Children's Legacyam. Sampradaya Parisuddhi, first one. Sampradaya Parisuddhi means unbroken, all the way from your Acharya, you put the line, you can go and touch Emperor's feet, Emperor's lotus feet. Nothing is interrupting. So that is the parampara we need. We don't want self-proclaimed Acharyas or anything. So we go through this one where there's a direct connection. So next one is Adi Guru. He taught Vedas to the Chaturbhuga Brahma. Brahma needs to create all of them. Samashti Srishti, Vyashti Srishti. Samashti Srishti, Bhagavan does all of them. Before Brahma, he creates all the Panjabhudams. Tattvatraya Chintanadigaram. So he creates all those things. And then he creates Brahma and then gives the Brahma to this one. And Brahma does all of them. And he's asking Perumal, I got all of them, nothing is moving. Anupravesam. Okay. Everybody got that. So Bhagavan is the one to do the Anupravesam and he is there everywhere. Another question. Other day. If Bhagavan is present everywhere, that is what in Gajendra Moksham, how beautifully each of these lines he says so beautifully visited with a Siddhantam. Bhagavan is present everywhere. When he is present everywhere, he may be present Swarubam or Sangalpam. His power can be Swarubam or Sangalpam. So Bhagavan everywhere is present. That means in our body is present everywhere. You say Bhagavan is sitting next to, like Vedas also say, two pakshis are sitting there. So when Krishna is there, when Krishna is doing, don't you think that Perumal's power, Perumal is not everywhere? Yes, he is there. At that point he is showing, okay, Swarubam, okay, he is everywhere. Same thing with your Atma. With your Atma is Anu. You know that. He is not a Vibhu. Your Atma is Anu, inside here. But how does it know what's happening in the leg, what's happening in the head, what's happening on the hand? Sankalpa. The sankalpam between you and the Perumal, what is the difference?
Only
correct. Yeah. Our sankalpam are controlled only in our body. Perumal sankalpam is controlled everywhere. That's it. So what Desikaki example he gives, Perumal sankalpam is very similar to king and the Agasam. So king has got power only in his rajyam, is not spread everywhere. Agasam is spread everywhere, but it does not have power. If you combine these two, so again all these things are what you call bullets from Rahasyadrasaram. So if you got all of them, this will help to understand. See, we are doing reverse. Actually, Sri Bhashyam, so many different ways they teach. All the Kalakshevam, big acharyas, they start from the third adhyayam. Why? Why they start from third adhyayam? You see, sadhana adhyayam. Like Desikan, what it does? Sara nishkarsha adhigaram. I tell you, this is the saram. Go and do prabhati, come back and listen the rest of them. Because we don't know. Butter's acharya, Parashara Butter, his acharya is actually Embar. Because when he brought the babies, he was telling Dwayam in a... So, Kuratharvan was sitting and he was telling him, Ashtakshara Mandram. Ashtaksharam, Ashtaksharathil Pirandu, Dwayathil Valandu, Dwaya Nishtaragave Irukka Venum, Ashtaksharam, he was teaching him. When he was teaching, then he says, oh, I cannot teach that one. You have to go to your acharya. Go and listen to the meaning. So Butter was going. Then he said, oh, please come. I don't know how many minutes you're going to be alive. Let me teach you now itself. So that is what he did. Okay. So what we are saying, Minnin Nelagila, Mannu Irakkaigal. What is the explanation they say? No.
We know how long that Minnal can be alive.
You know Minnal will stay for 2 seconds. Do you know you have 2 seconds? That is the Swabadesam. Minnin nilayila munnu irakkaigal. Even Minnal you know already, but we don't know about yours. Okay. Coming back here, is the first preceptor and the moksha pradhanam. Bhagavan is the only one who can give moksham. Again, go back to the 6th one. It has to be cast in concrete your head. Srishti, Sthiti, Samharam, Anupravesam, Moksha Pradhanam, Shriyapadittum. All the 6 only for him. Even if you go to Moksham, even for the Nitya Suris, none of them can touch it. That is why you will never become Bhagavan. There is no Aikyam. We will be a Shariram for him. Enna sonnalam, whatever it is, however close your wife is, she cannot take your headache. It is your headache. Similarly here, there are certain things. How Desikan explains this one? When you go to Moksham, Paripurna Brahmanubhavam, we get the Anandam like Perumal. How we get the Anandam like Perumal? Because Bhagavan is going outside, go work, earn the money, Amma cooks, putting on the dining table, small baby eats along with all of them. Baby never earns the money. Baby never cooks, but eats the same food. But baby eats whatever the food it wants. Sarshtida, not the whole thing. Not like what father eats. Okay, all of them, remember that one. Sarshtida, mochatale, even though people do different kaingaryam, the anandam is same. Kaingaryam may be different. The quantity and quality may be different. But anandam is the same. Coming back here. So Bhagavan is the one who gives a moksha. This is a refresher course like a Ragasatra Saram. So Vitsakshayana. Okay. Somebody was asking the other day, when Perumal do the procession outside, Utsavar Vidhi Purapadala Varche, they will do Shadari Saripa. Shadari Sarigache, Vitsakshayana Saripa. Appa, they are asking, why they are not doing for Garudan? Why they are not doing for the Anantan Adisheshanaku? Okay? Remember, Vishwasenarke Saripa. Yeh avarge Sarikala abdin kekarade. Sadarina, we are assuming it's a Sadagopan, but it's Perumal Nodiya Padugai. So, anal Vishwasenarke undu. Even though Namalvar comes below him, he is God, because his Perumal is the Thiruvedi Padugai. So, but the reason why they are asking, Vishwasenarke is also eternal, Nityasuri dana. You don't need to suri then.
Well, again, he gives the rain to him and come down.
Innu idandalithavarai shanambukku yanadevi navarguru kal nirevanengi acharya parambarai. Garudan and Anandan is not Acharya Parampara for us. That is the reason why they do the Sadhari. So that's why Sadhari is so important for us, because Acharya's Padvi is coming on us. Okay. So what happens is Perumal is teaching to Thayar. Thayar is teaching to Vishwaksena. Vishwaksena is teaching to Namalva. No Garudan. No Vishwamitra Vasishta. None of them. So it jumps over there because it's in the Acharya Goshti. That is the reason, okay? So, Vishwaksena taught Namalvar. Namalvar is called Prabanna Jana Kudastar. We are all Prabannas. Why? Mainly because of Namalvar. Namalvar is the one in Thiruvayimuri. He has shown every single instant. We are all completely, utterly useless people. We cannot do anything. And what he says, we go and hold Bhagavan's Thiruvadi, lotus feet. And just because you are saying, Kayal Agadavan, Ennala Yedume Panamudiyadu, you are asking Bhagavan out of his Karunyam, he gives you moksham. That path is shown by Namalvar. That is why he is the leader of all the Prabannas. Prabanna Jana Kudastar. There is no caste here. Okay. Even though he was born on that one, because Bhagavan has made like that one to be born. So these are all taught by Namalvar. But for all these things, I want to say, the next snippet I was writing for 2 minutes, something else came. What is the connection between Ramanujar and Tamil? Okay. Imperumanar, he wrote Sribhashyam. Most of the Sribhashyam he wrote with all the Nalayara Divya Prabandham and its meaning. Ide konde Imperumanar urunga viduvar Acharya Hridayam. Acharya Azhagamanavala Perumal Nayanar is the Vadakka Thiruvidhi Pillai Swami's son, Pillalokacharya's brother. He has written on that one. Idai kondu Tamil Divya Prabandhathai vechindu, keeping the Tamil Divya Prabandham, he is going to interpret the Vedas and Upanishads to write the Sribhashyam. Not even a single word. Namalvar Thiruvadigalai Sharanam, Maran Thiruvadigalai Sharanam, Maranukku Namaskaram, never mentioned any of that. So, people are asking, what is the connection between Imperumana and Tamil? If you really look at that one. Ramanuja Nutrandadi, you go there and see, I think it's 44th Pashuram. In that one, he says, Arindar, Mundrum, and that less order. What he knows through Yel Isai Nadagam in Tamil. Tamil different. Yel means prose kind of a thing. Isai, musical one. Natagam, you know, drama kind of a thing. All the three have to master first to know Tamil. Very good. And Imperumana knew all of them. That is why he said Tamil. Very few Thaniyans we can see Imperumana has written. One or two here and there we would say like that one. And he has not written any of the thing. But all of them is called Thirupavaijiyar. And he is the one constituted this Pallandu and Vanga Kadal Gadenda, Sitran Chirigale, all of them in our Satumurai, we have to say. And he is the one who has established the Arayar Sevai has to be done in Srirangam and everything. So he's got amazing qualities and to treat both Dravida Vedam and Samskrita Vedam. But he wrote everything here mainly because in those days, when you want to do the Tarkam, debates, argument and everything, when everybody was talking only in Vedas and Samskritam, he has to talk like that. Unfortunately, we never heard Upanyasam directly from Imperumana. When Srirangam, think about it, in the Ranganathan Sannadhi, in the Mandapam, he is sitting there, Kurathalvan, Parasarabhattar, Angalalvan, all other people are sitting, Embar, and he is giving the Upanyasam, listen what he would be talking. So he would be throwing all the Vyaprabandham, and all the Samskrita Vedam and Sribhashyam and everything. But nobody has captured those things. So Imperumanar, in his Kalakshepam and everything he has given, but he never wrote any of the Tamil Pramandams and everything. But all the things, whatever we see in the Ramanuja Nutrandari and everything shows, is very, very highly prolific in Tamil. That is why he can understand all the Divya Prabandham. In fact, in Divya Prabandham, many places when he was taught, he was tested. And he comes back and says, this is not good. Take this word and put it over here. It gives a different meaning. because Alavandar is amazing. I don't think there's no Acharya can be. He has got six Sishyas, so many Sishyas. Five Sishyas, they taught Ramanuja. All the five of them learned from Alavandar. So Alavandar, without Alavandar, there is no Sharanagati. He is the one establishes Sharanagati for us. Because he forgot and made a mistake. That is the reason why we always are thankful to Ananda Padmanabha Swami in Thiruvananthapuram. He is the one made Alavandar to go there. So Alavandar goes there and keep on praying to him, and then he realized, today is the date I had to go to Kurugai Kavalappan. He was telling me to tell the Yoga Ragasyam. I missed it. Kesavandamar. So he went there and then he went back to Kurugai Kavalappan. He's already gone. Kurugai Kavalappan said, 5 minutes before I die, I'll teach you. You came late, you. Then he felt so sad. First of all, you don't have a discipline to come at right on time. How can I teach you the Yoga Sastram? But Bhagavan delayed him. Why? Because he knows Alavandar missed only the time. There are tons and tons of people going to miss everything. Mm-hmm. For them to go to moksham, we need the Prabhati Margam. Mm-hmm. So because Alavandar missed that one, and at that time he was praying to Ananda Padmanabha Swami. Mm-hmm. Ananda Padmanabha Swami magnetically attracted him so that he forgot Alavandar. So that is why we always have to say thanks to him. He is the one who helped us. Just like sometimes we always say thanks to Ramanuja's wife. Because of her only we got the Acharyan. Okay. So, Perumal taught Thayar. Thayar taught Nama Vishwaksena. That is in the Moksham. So, Vishwaksena taught Nammalvar. And Nammalvar goes all the way over here. Nadamuni, Yamanamuni, Ramanujamuni, Munitrayam, we say all of them. But of all the Acharyas, Ramanuja is an amazing one. மணவாள மாமுனிகள் ரைட்ஸ் இன் உபதேச ரத்னமாலை ஓராண்படியாய் உபதேசித்தார் முன்னோர் ஏறார் எதிராசர் என்னொருளால் பருலகில் ஆசையோடுவர்க்கெல்லாம் கூறும் ஆரியர்கள் என்று பேசி வரம்பு அறுத்தார் பின். பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஸ்லோகம். பிஃபோர் தட் ஈச் ஆச்சாரியா வில் பி டீச்சிங் ஒன்லி ஒன் சிஷ்யா அண்ட் தே வில் டெஸ்ட் தம் டு லேர்ன் ஒன் வேதா 12 இயர்ஸ் 4 வேதாஸ் டு லேர்ன் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம் 48 இயர்ஸ் தென் ஆல் அதர்ஸ் Your lifespan itself is only 15 those days. By the time you learned all of them, you would be gone, and that Acharya would be gone, it will be dead. So Ebhirmanar saw that one. No, we cannot do this one. All other Acharyas, Anuvritti Prasanna Acharyar. Ebhirmanar called Kripamatra Prasanna Acharyar. Just basically compassion. So he went on top of the madal on this Goburam and Trikoshtiyur and says, everybody come. He did not give the ashtaksharam to everybody. I run the class. Not one, 10 people can come. 100 people can sit. Asyodarkallam kurum. Only the thing what you need is to have the desire to go to moksham. That's all. Anybody who has got the desire to go to moksham, that is only qualification. Don't think, Swami Deshan goes even one more high level. I don't know Veda. I don't know Divya Prabandham. I don't know the Acharam. I don't know the Anushtanam. When you say, I don't know, Veda says, we're going to see, that's the first line we're going to see, you know more than anybody else. The more I don't know you keep saying, because you're putting all the way down. The lower you have, Perumal say, Karunyam over here, Sausilyam. Okay. This is the one what I want to show here, Desigan's definition. Asayesha chidachit prakaram brahma ekameva tattvam A42. On that one, when you look at the Visittadvaita Siddhantam, Advaita, I went a little further. Okay, let's go, this one. Nadamuni, Yamanamuni. Nado bhakyam pravartam. பகுவி உபஜிதம் யாமுனேய பிரபந்தை திராதம் சம்யக் யதீந்திரை இதம் அகிலதம கரிசனம் தரிசனம் நக. பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஸ்லோகா ஃப்ரம் தேசிகா. எவ்ரிபடி டேக்ஸ் திஸ் ஒன். நாதோபக்யம் பிரவிருத்தம். வி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் சே தேங்க்ஸ் டு நாதமுனிகள். வை? வித்தவுட் நாதமுனிகள் தெர் இஸ் நோ திவ்ய பிரபந்தம். See, I'll tell more on this one when we do the simultaneously Bhagavad Vishayam. Nadamunigal Yoga Dasaila Nammalvar came and he gave the Nalayana Divya Prabandham. Many people don't accept that research wise. So those things are not possible. Nadamunigal has went into many, many places, temples. They may be reciting that one. He collected all of them. And some of them he has inserted also. That is how the Nalayana Divya Prabandham has come. That is some research people say. We have to, because you should not be startled when somebody says like that. So they say, we don't know any of those things. It looks so beautiful. It is Divyam. What Bhagavan has given, whatever the way he has given, it's great. We don't want to dissect all of them. But there are people who say like that one. But Nadamunigal in Yoga, they say he got all of them. Nadobakyam Pravurtam Bahu Yubachidam Yamuneya Prabandai. Nadamunigal, Yamanamunigal, Ramanujamuni. Without them, our Vaishnava Sampradayam would have gone. Without Nadamuni, Dravida Vedam would be gone. Without Yamanamuni, Prabhati would be gone. Without Embhramana, Visitta Adeda Siddhantam. When somebody says Visitta Dvaidam, what do you know?
Sariraga
Sastram. Correct. That is Sariraga Sastram. That is the most Visitta Advaidam. Qualified monoism. What is qualified? There is only one Brahman. That Brahman has got everything else. Chit and Achit are its Sariram. And that is what I wrote here. Asesha Chidachit Prakaram Brahma Egam Evatatvam. Brahman has been qualified by the sentient and non-sentient. Okay, there's only one thing. Pragaram Pragari. Amsam Amsi. Okay, so that is what it is. Bhagavan is inside. We are all very similar to the Visheshyam Visheshanam. We are all like qualities for him. Okay. Think about the Abharanam for Perumal, just like that one. That's all we are. All the Chit and Achit are forming is body. Sariraga Shastram, that is the Sariraga Mimamsa. Whole Brahma Sutram we are going to see. This is what Krishna told in chapter 13 of Bhagavad Gita also. Okay. So, ours is called Sri Sampradayam. That is why it's called Sri Bhashyam. Sri Sampradayam. Without Sri, Bhagavan is empty suit. We know that. That is the reason why it is called Sri Sampradayam. Tattva Hida Purushartham. Reality, root and rewards. Three R's. Okay. Pratyaksham Anumana Sabda Pramanam. Only three. Chetana Achetanas are inseparable body. Like yesterday we told. Naan endri nee illai. Naranane. Nee endri naan illai. So you cannot say without me, I cannot say. Whatever it is, any place you go, any yugams you cross, nothing, any time space, Bhagavan and you are like this. He is always a seshi, you are a seshan. He is a paramatma, you are a servant. Three things, supports,
controls,
owns. That's it. That is what we're going to get in there next. So Bhagavan is always a supporter, he is the owner, he is the controller. We are all puppets. We may think like that we are doing. He gives a little kind of swadantram. And with that swadantram, he's watching what you can do. Okay? Just like a cow is tied to the stick. It can go in the circumference only. Okay. So, what we see here, Asesha Chidachit Pragaram Brahmam Egameva Tattvam. Remember that first part of the line only I put it. Then we'll go more into, when we go into the Brahma Sutram, how Desikan explains that one. Okay. Relation between Ishwaran and Chetana, Sarira, Sariri, body and soul, Pragara, Pragari, so many different kinds of them are there. Jagat is real. It is not Maya, but it is destroyable. You know that. We saw the nice poetry yesterday.
Yeah.
And the snippets I put that one, very nicely it says, everything is gone. Krishna is lying down in the alalai. So, and moksham is a place. It's a place, not in the mindset. Jiva Mukti, it's not. Okay. And Brahman Nirguna, that is what Shankara calls that one. In the sense, it is called no impure qualities. Okay, that's all it is. We conclude before we go. Keno Upanishad says, Yasya Madam తస్య మదం మదం యస్య న వేదస అవిఘ్యాదం విజానధాం విఘ్యాదం అవిజానధాం. వన్ హూ థింగ్స్ హీ డస్ నాట్ నో యాక్చువల్లీ హీ నోస్ అండ్ వైస్ వర్సా. అండ్ దోస్ హూ అండర్స్టాండ్ వెరీ క్లియర్లీ దే డూ నాట్ అండర్స్టాండ్. దర్ ఇస్ అ వర్డ్ ఇన్ సంస్కృతం కాల్ ప్రమాదం. ఉపన్యాసం ఎప్పుడైనా ప్రమాదం అందుదినా దట్ మీన్స్ యూ డోంట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ఎనీథింగ్. వన్ సీ ఇన్ ది డిక్షనరీ ప్రమాదం మీన్స్ యూ డోంట్ నో. ప్రమాదం అందుదినా యూ డోంట్ నో ఎనీథింగ్. ప్రమాదం మీన్స్ నథింగ్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్. దోస్ వుడ్ నాట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ యాక్చువల్లీ అండర్స్టాండ్. ఐ టుక్ దిస్ వే ఫ్రమ్ ది కేనోపనిషత్. కేనోపనిషత్ వెరీ కేన మీన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ హూమ్. దట్ ఈస్ వెర్ వీఆర్ స్టార్టింగ్. కేనోపనిషత్ ఈస్ ఎ బ్యూటిఫుల్ వన్. అండ్ ది కేనోపనిషత్, రీజన్ వై ఐ టేక్ కేనోపనిషత్, ఆల్ ది అగ్ని వాయు వర్ణన్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీబడి బిఫోర్ దమ్ దర్ ఇస్ ఎ యక్షన్. దర్ ఇస్ ఎ లెట్స్ ఎ సమ్ మాయావి కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ పర్సన్ కమ్స్ హీ టాక్స్ అండ్ హీ వాస్ ఆస్కింగ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ అగ్ని కెన్ యూ డూ నా ఓ ఐ కెన్ బర్న్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. సో హీ ఆస్క్డ్ సంథింగ్ టు బర్న్. నథింగ్ యూ కెన్ డూ. వాయు యూ కెన్ డూ. ఇంద్రన్ ఆల్ నన్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ కెన్ డూ. దెన్ హీ ఈస్ ఆస్కింగ్ హూ ఇస్ దిస్ గై. ఐ థాట్ వీఆర్ ఆల్ పవర్ఫుల్. దట్ ఈస్ ది బ్రహ్మం. హూ ఇస్ టీచింగ్ దిస్ వన్? ఉమా మహేశ్వరి. పార్వతి విల్ బి టీచింగ్ దట్ వన్. దిస్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ బ్రహ్మం అప్పుడే. సో ఆల్ దిస్ లోవర్ పీపుల్ సడన్లీ అండర్స్టాండ్. దట్ ఈస్ వై మ్యాక్స్ ముల్లర్ అండ్ ఆల్ అదర్ పీపుల్ దే రైట్ ఫస్ట్ ఆల్ దిస్ ఆ బిఫోర్ వేదాస్ పీరియడ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ పాంథియిజం. దే ఆర్ ఆల్ గోయింగ్ ఫర్ సెవరల్ గాడ్స్ అండ్ దెన్ దే కమింగ్ టు వన్ గాడ్. నో ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్. ఈవెన్ ఇన్ ఇంద్ర కేనోపనిషత్ సేస్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ దే థింక్ దే హ్యావ్ పవర్. They were fooled. They are asking, who? By who? By who? By who? Whole Brahma Sutram, by Sri Bhashyam, by who this has been created? By who we are all moving? By who we get moksham? By who we get this anandam? So that is why I picked the Keno Upanishad to start with that one. He says, we start with scratch, clean slate. We don't understand and from which we are going to start and learn everything. Next one. భగవత్ రామానుజర్. వి కమింగ్ టు ది శ్రీభాష్యం ఇంట్రొడక్షన్. వీ ఓంట్ కమింగ్ టు శ్రీభాష్యం యట్. వీ కమింగ్ టు ది లిల్ మోర్ ఇన్ టు రామానుజర్ అండ్ దెన్ వీ కమింగ్ టు ది మంగళ శ్లోక అండ్ దెన్ ఇనిషియల్ లైన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎంబెరుమానాత్ అండ్ దెన్ ఫస్ట్ సూత్రం విల్ కమ్. సో ఐ థాట్ వీ విల్ ఫినిష్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ దమ్. ఇఫ్ నాట్ విల్ కంటిన్యూ, ఇట్ డజన్ మ్యాటర్. సో ఎనీథింగ్ వీ స్టార్ట్ విత్ 10 classes, ఇట్ గోస్ టు 80 classes. సో బట్ ఇట్స్ గుడ్. సో వీ ఆల్వేస్ ఐ ట్రై టు రిపీట్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ వట్ వీ న్యూ బిఫోర్. వన్ క్వశ్చన్ మైట్ కమ్, దిస్ ఈస్ ఎ వెరీ ఫన్నీ థింగ్, విచ్ వన్ కేమ్ ఫస్ట్? వీ ఆల్వేస్ సే వ్యాస భగవాన్ క్లాసిఫైడ్ ది వేదాస్ అండ్ దెన్ ఈ రోడ్ మహాభారతం అండ్ దెన్ ఈ రోడ్ భాగవతం. ఈ వాస్ వెరీ felt frustrated, then he wrote the Brahma Sutra. Not so. In Bhagavad Gita, it is coming from the mouth of Krishna about Brahma Sutra. That is what I am taking it here. Rushibhir Bahudha Gidam Chandobhir Vividai Bhridat Brahma Sutra Padaischaiva Hedumadbhir Vinischidaihi. The truth is body and soul relation is telling in the 13th chapter. So in the 13th chapter it is Shariram Shariri, body and soul. All the chit and achit forms the body for Bhagavan. So there's only one thing exists, Bhagavan and Abhridak Siddham. Abhridak Siddham means inseparable. You cannot separate that. Abhridak Siddhi, Desikan's favorite word. இலைதந்ததாரகனாய் நேமைக்கும் இறைவனுமாய் இலது ஒன்றையனா வகையெல்லாம் தனதெனும் எந்தையுமாய். ஸோ வி டோல்ட் ஆன் தட் ஒன் தி த்ரீ திங்ஸ் சப்போர்ட்ஸ் கண்ட்ரோல்ஸ் ஓன். தூளை ஒன்று இலை என நின்ற துழாய் முடியான் உடம்பாய். துழாய் முடியான் உடம்பாய். தூளை ஒன்று இலை என தெர் இஸ் நோபடி ஈக்குவல் டு ஹிம். ஒத்தார் மிக்காரை இளையாய மாமாயா நம்மாழ்வர்ஸ் இஸ் டேக்கிங் தேர் டு ஷோ இஸ் ஏ அவனுக்கு உடம்பாய். திஸ் இஸ் நாட் காசு கொடுத்து பண்ணுற வேலை இல்லை. வி ஆர் நாட் சர்வன்ஸ் கெட்டிங் சம் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ஏ வேஜ். துளை ஒன்று இளைய நின்ற துழாய் முடியான் உடம்பாய். விலையின்றி நாம் அடியோம். வேதியர் மெய்ப்பொருளே, தேசியன் ஸ்பாஷ்ரம், இட்ஸ் லைக் ஈச் ஒன் இஸ் லைக் அன் ஆட்டம் பாம். இட்ஸ் காட் சோ மெனி திங்ஸ். அதிகார சங்கிரகம் கம்ஸ் பிரதான பிரதிதந்திரம். இன் தேசிகன்ஸ் ரகசியத்திர சாரம் தந்திரம், பிரதிதந்திரம், பிரதான பிரதிதந்திரம். தேர் இஸ் சம்திங் எக்ஸ்க்ளூசிவ்லி ஃபார் யூ, நோபடி ஹஸ் காட் இட். சார், திஸ் ஜுவல்லரி ஐ மேட் ஸ்ட்ரேட் மார்க், ஒன்லி யூ ஆர் த ஒன்லி ஒன் வேரிங், நோபடி எல்ஸ் கேன் மேக் இட். தே சே லைக் தட் ஒன், வாட் யூ காட் வெரி ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் டு ஸ்ரீ வைஷ்ணவம், விச் நோபடி எல்ஸ் ஹஸ் காட். திஸ் இஸ் சரீர ஆத்ம பாவம். அண்ட் 13th chapter, Krishna highlights on that. There he says, Rushibir Bahudha Geetam. Rishigal, they're told by so many different ways. Chandobir Vividaihi. And in their Veda Smritis and everything, they have told everything so many different ways. Or even in the Vedas, because it's a revelations. So Rishis are telling that one. Brahma Sutrai Padaishyaiva Hedu Madbir Vinishchiraihi. He says in Brahma Sutram, these are all undoubtedly ascertained, Krishna says. Brahma Sutram is just Sariraga Sastram only. That is from Krishna's words. So you cannot interpret in any different way. Okay. So that is why Embhirmana, when you took it from the Vriddhi, from Bodhayanar, Bodhayanar initially interpreted everything based on Visishtadvaitam. And Embhirmana looked at everything and says, this is the correct thing. And that is how we should be interpreting. So you look at the Brahma Sutram, you look at everything, this is how we should be interpreting. Rather than, I have some preconceived idea, how can I inject it here? Like yesterday I said, you have to see what you are. I want to become an IAS officer. My acharya used to say, yeah, this guy has not even passed the third grade. Mm-hmm. You have to see what you are, then you have to go for that. What's some...
So when Vyasa
Bhagavan
wrote Rama Sutram, then
Bodhayanar
has already interpreted it.
Correct.
Script, yeah? And then that has been used as a
reference. Correct. Right? After Bodhayanar, Dangar, Dramidar, Gugadevar, Balaram, so many people have come there after that one. But none of them, because Embhirmana looked at that one, is very short. One, you don't have any refuting other religions. What happens if somebody comes and asks? So all those things are missing. But Bodhayanar Vriddhi is huge. பகவத் போதாயன கிருதாம் விஸ்தீர்ணாம். சோ தட் இஸ் ஹவ் ஹி ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ். விஸ்தீர்ணாம், இட்ஸ் சோ ஹியூஜ். சோ தட் இஸ் வை ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு ரைட் சம்திங் நாட் டு ஷார்ட் லைக் டங்கர் அண்ட் திரமிடர், நாட் டு எலாபரேட் லைக் போதாயனர், சம்திங் இன் பிட்வீன் பீப்புள் கேன் யூஸ். தி ப்ராப்ளம் இஸ் எம்பெருமானார் தாட் எவ்ரிபடி வுட் பி இன்டெலிஜென்ட் like those people stayed close to him in those days. That is a problem. And as the time comes by, it is so difficult. Sribhasham, adhik explanation, we can't even understand any of them. Okay. So, Rushibir Bahudha Geetam. So, Krishna says, now we are asking, how Krishna knows all of them? Well, Krishna knows everything, including what is going to come. Just like Rama says, don't believe Buddha. Buddha is a thridan. Rama says, that's a Ramayana slogan there. It says, how does he know? Bhagavan knows everything. This is repeated several times. Like Arjuna in that one, he says, Arjuna, when I told this Bhagavad Gita to Adityan, Suryan, Krishna, I thought you were telling to me. Krishna is laughing. How many times I told this? None of them listened. So I had to repeat again. So commentaries for Brahma Sutra, Bodhayana Rishi is called Vriddhi. Tangar, Dramidar, Gugadeva, none of them is available now. Everything is gone. Closer to Ramanuja period, Shankara, Bhaskara, Yadava, they are all written, all those things. So Ramanuja very carefully, Purvacharyaha Sankshibuhu, that's how he writes. Purvacharyaha, Shankara, not you. Above that one, Purvacharya, I mean lived a long time back, those Acharyas. அவளனுடைய தேர் ஐடியாஸ், தேர் கான்செப்ட்ஸ், தேர் டிசிஷன்ஸ், வி ஆர் ரைட்டிங் தட் ஒன், நாட் எனி திங் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ஃப்ரம் தட். தட்ஸ் வாட் ஹி ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ். ப்ரீவியஸ் கமெண்ட்ரிஸ் நாட் தி ப்ராப்பர் சைஸ் ஆர் நாட் தி ரைட் பெர்ஸ்பெக்டிவ். ராமானுஜா வாண்ட் டு ஃபாலோ போதாயன விருத்தி. ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் எ லிட்டில் ஸ்டோரி தேர். ஈ ராமானுஜா யூ வாண்டட் டு கெட் தி போதாயன விருத்தி அண்ட் இட் இஸ் நாட் அவைலபிள். தே செட் இட் இஸ் அவைலபிள் இன் சங்கர் மடம் இன் காஷ்மீர். ஸோ ஈ கோஸ் அலாங் வித் தி குரத்தாழ்வான் அண்ட் தென் ஈ கெட்ஸ் தட் ஒன். They ask him to look at it. or they gave him for only one day or something. That's what happened. They took it away. Then Kura Thalvan said, don't worry, I got all of them, Xerox in my head. So photographic memory. And then when he comes back down to south, then Ramanuj asks, okay, you tell. So he tells Bodha in a Vriddhi, and then Embiramana thinks about it, and then he gets really confused. Then Kura Thalvan gives the Alvar's Pasuram. Ah, this is how he explained. Okay, Kura Thalvan, start writing. So Kura Thalvan starts writing that one. So that is the way Sri Bhashyam was written. Then, after Ramanuja saw the Bodhayana Vriddhi, he came, he wrote. Long time after that one, he went on Vijayatra. Again, he went to the same place, Kashmir. At that time, Saraswati was there. She was asking, well, you think that you have done all of them. I want you to explain. The famous word, Tasya Eda Kapyasam Pundarike Meva Makshini. Okay, why don't you, Chantogya Upanishad words. Tasya Yada Kapyasam Pundarigam Eva Makshini. Kapyasam, how you break that word. Kabi Asanam, that means the Prishtabhagam of the monkey. That is the stupid way of doing that one. That is not the way. Because we are looking at a sacred and holy one, which cannot be. So beautifully he has explained. There are a lot of arguments also. When you go and look into, we are looking Sri Bhashyam. If you look at the Sankara Bhashyam, Madhva Bhashyam, all other people, so they come and refute so many of them. Just like we do, they also do. So Embiramana's interpretation when he says, this is like a kum and then pibadi, so it is pulling the water and the sun is doing that one. From where it is pulling? Only from the lotus flower it is pulling. So Perumal's eyes are like the lotus flowers. Embiramana are so brilliant. But that idea, he didn't get it. It is from the Alvars. So many places Alvars are told, Tamarekkannane. So you took it from there. I didn't understand Vedas. Now I understand from the Alvars. Every place Alvars are told like that. So many Alvars have told. Kannum Tamarai, Adiyum Tamarai, everything is a Tamarai. Perumal Thirumugam, Perumal Thiruvadi, Perumal eyes, Perumal body, everything is Tamarai. That is why what do? You go to Tamarai Thadagam and you want to go and take samslesham. Neerada Podivir Anda, that's what it says. So he got all of them from here. So beautifully Tamil explains the Sanskrit. I don't know why they do the Padam. It is wrong. So he explained it differently. Even now they say what Embiramana explained may not be correct because there's no word in dictionary like that. To breaking this way is, well, we don't want to go to Vyagrana Sastram here, but we just take it like that because there are so many of them nowadays and not available. It might be those words are there. Some of the words, even Alvars have used, nothing is in practice. We don't even know any of them. So it could have been like that one. So what he says finally to Sharada, Lord Sriman Narayana's eyes are like that of the lotus. That lotus is blossomed by the sun. So, Thamarai Kannan, identifier, Ubayalingadigaranam, will see that one. Two identifiers for Perumal. There we will say, the identifier is, one is, Samastha Kalyana Gunatmagan, Agliheya Pratyanigan. Shouldn't remember, because we all told Saranagari Gedyam. So, Sri Bhashyam what we learn? Bhakti Yoga. Saranagari Gedyam we learn? Prabhati Yoga. Okay. So these two Ubayalinga Adhigaranatle, that is what he says. But when you come to Desi Sampradayam and everything, yes, that's all good. But we go to the very simple one. What are the two things Ubayalinga Adhigaranam, what we say over here? Tamarekkannan, one of them. The other one is Prati. Evanude Thirumarbala vandu Marudani Pusiya annude karai irukko avandhan Narayanan avandhan Parabrahmam. Prati vechina namma solrom with the Sri. Srayade, Yidi, Sri, all these six qualities we say. Sraddhaya Devo, Devatvam Ashnudhe. Veda says, Sraddha. Sraddha means Mahalakshmi. Only because of Mahalakshmi, Narayana, you get the divinity. Otherwise, you are not divine. You are an ordinary person like me. Because of the Thayar you are. So that is why. In Ubayalingadhigaranam in Sri Bhashyam when we say Samastha Kalyana Gunatmagan Agliheya Pratyanigan. But for us to easily remember, Alvars have shown only two things. Thamarekkannan Thirumagal Marbiyan. That's all. Agalagille Nereyum Endru. Indha rendu dhaan namakku. Okay. coming back here, Sharda Devi was very pleased and says, what you have written is an amazing explanation for Brahma Sutra. And she put it on her head. And she gave, this is called Sri Bhashyam. Okay. And from today onwards, you will be called Bhashyakara. Bhashya means explanatory text, treatise, whatever you want, discussion. So you will be called Bhashyakara. Nothing is called, that's why our says a Sri Sampradayam, Shankara Bhashyam, Madhva Bhashyam. None of them is called. This is the only thing is called Sri Bhashyam. So amazing, because that's why. Remember the three Gitas when we told, Bhagavad Gita, Venu Gita, Uddhava Gita. Venu Gita, Achit. Bhagavad Gita, Ishwaran. Uddhava Gita, Chetan. Mono. Venu Gita, based on what is Venu. Bhagavad Gita, based on what he told. Uddhava Gita, based on the disciple, not on the teacher. That is why Uddhava Gita is so important. So I was recently reading Swami Narayan, that Sampradayam is called Uddhava Sampradayam. Uddhava Sampradayam. And recently, Swami Narayan was about 200 years back. That's what it is actually. So they changed at that time, they are coming into the Swami Narayan principle and everything. It is Uddhava Sampradayam. And I always felt, I don't know why our acharyas did not take Uddhava Gita that much, because it's so convoluted. But I thought this is most ideal for Prabandhan. I don't think nowhere else Krishna told so beautifully, Samadrik Vicharaswakam. Everything is a Yadida Manacham Vasa, Sakshurbhyam Shravanadibhigi, Nashwaram Grihyamanancha, Vidhimaya Manomayam. I don't think nowhere else you can see what a Prabandhan can follow so beautifully said. So, at bringing the Uddhava over here to show how great he is. So, similarly, Uddhava Gita is called here, it's not based on Ramanuja. Sri Bhashyam, because it is showing Pirati. Only through Pirati we will go to him. How amazing this thing. So, then it's also common, what he does is, while embarking any large task you take, you always do Prarthana first. So, that is one of the beautiful thing. My Acharya, when he says, open the Shankara Bhashyam, immediately they talk about Perumal. No Acharya Vandanam. No Guru Vanakkam. Nothing. In hours is only. So the other day I was talking in the Gujarati Satsangam, Srinathji Satsangam. So we need Acharya. Without Acharya we are not going anywhere. Even if you go to Idula, Srivajana Bhushanathla Solache, Vedarthangal Arudhi Iduvadu, Acharya Thirvediya Uttaragam, first and last. Those are the bookends. Vedarthangal Ardhiyudur. What the Vedas, the internal meaning of the, all the Vedantas is Acharya and Thiruvadi is the highest. Nothing else. That's all they got it. So without Acharya, we are not going anywhere. So then the lady afterwards, she come back and said, look here, they said all you have to say only Krishna. That's right. Maybe that's some pradayam is like that. We are not saying anything. In hours, what you have shown, when you do Samasranam and Bharanyasam and everything, the mandatory duty for you, not only Ashtacharam, Charmaslavam, Dvayam, you have to tell every day, you have to tell Acharya and Thaniyan. So that is why what we do, when we do the Sandhyavandanam for male, at the end of that one, Siranga Mangala Nidhyam, when we finish that one, you do this Agilavana Janmasteva Bangadi Lele. That is the Sivashyam. And then you finish your Acharya and Thaniyan there itself. So at least you will tell three times. So we kept in the practice. The same thing, woman also, you had to find. So Acharya and Thaniyan, at least once a day you should tell. Because that is a small gratitude. Desiyan says so beautifully in all of them. Mayanam kanayallan, potrigopadum, pundiyil goludum, pungubugai shatravalapadum, chattralavu munnam petradarke. What can you do? Even Krishna, you call is a Mayan, he's struggling to find out what he can give it to Acharya. If he cannot do that one, what you can do? All you can do is talk about his glories, praise him, always be grateful to him. That's what he said. So our sampradayam is based on Acharya. And the best Acharya, when you go on the line, finally is Pirati. That is why it is called Sri Sampradayam in this Acharya Goshti. So what he does is first to remove the vigram, he talks about two slokas. Oh, okay. I might have mentioned this one. We have the Acharya Parambara coming from Narayana all the way to your Acharya. Or your Acharya to Narayana. Arohanam and Avarohanam. You can have that one. Which one should you follow? Okay. When we do the Kalakshebam, like Sri Bhashyam and Ragasetra Saram Kalakshebam, they start from Narayana only. All other times, Envidandalitavarai Sharanam book. Okay. All other times. So, following that one, when he does that one, he starts with Narayana. Imperumanar starts that one, Sri Bhashyam. Agilabhuvana Janmastema Bhangadilile Vinada Vivida Bhudaurada Rakshayagadikshe Sudhishirasi Vidipte Brahmani Srinivase Bhavad Mama Parasmin Semushi Bhakti Rubha. Within the first 5-6 classes, you will memorize this. We will repeatedly tell so many times this one. We will parse this sentence. The greatest, how beautifully, Imperumanar, if you would have written all slokas, how great it would be. How beautifully, so rhyming and so sweet when he writes all of them. And not only, he compressed everything. The 4 lines talks about all the things he is going to talk in Sri Bhashyam. All the 4 adhyayams, what he does, he tells all of them. Agila Bhuvana Janmastema Bhangadi Leele. For whom the creation, sustenance and dissolution is a mere sport. Leele. In the Bhagavan Udaya Srishti ki enna phalan adu nikata. Leele dan phalan. That is what Acharya says. Why he does that one? Leele. They can say, no, not necessarily. It is not play for him. Why? Correct. Because Daya Sadagam, he says, Achide Visitan Playe Jandun Avaloke Jada Nirveda Karana Kale Bare Yogam Vidarasa Vishasailana the Karunetvam. All the Atmas are in Pralayagalam. It is no Nama Ruba Milamarka. You cannot do anything. We have to give a Shariram. So when you give a Shariram, then only it will do an action. It will accumulate Punyam. Then it will get a better Janma. Then one day you will do Sharanagati, come to Moksham. So don't say this is play. Maybe that is also one agenda inside his play to take some of these people. But main reason why Bhagavan is doing Srishti is to take these people to Moksham. Desiya's view. Okay. So, Bhirmanar says in Gita Bhashyam, Sandhyavandanatanala no palan, people are saying. He says, no. No direct benefit, I accept. Sandhyavandanam has got a benefit. Without Sandhyavandanam, we cannot do Aradhanam. Without Sandhyavandanam, you are not qualified for anything. The least job a Brahmanam can do is the Nimantranam. Nimantranam is the one when they do the Shraddham, where you go and eat. They have Vishyadeva, Brahman, Siddhinyava, Pitrudevada. So they sit and eat on that one. To eat that one, what is the minimum qualification you need is only Trigala Sandhyavandanam. Abhastamba Rishi. That is what he did. When somebody wanted great Rishi to come for my mother's Shraddham, I want Vedavit, who knows Brahma Vidya. So he called Abhastamba to come. Abhastamba eat all of them and finally Swami, tripyade, when he is asking at that time, he said like this. When he poured the water, the jalaruba water, stambam, abde solid ayirthu. Rekala vindhi kata, Swami, what abhijaram did? You are looking like a fool. To do the nimantranam, you don't need a Vedavit. All you need is basically Trigala Sandhyavandanam. Nothing else you needed. So, next time, when you watch in your home and everything, when they do Shraddham, people who come and eat there don't ask any questions. All they have to do is Sandhyavandanam. They don't have to know any Vedas. That is Abhastamba Rishi. Sorry. So, I don't know why I come to that. Chain of thought goes somewhere. I don't know why I come to that one. Agilabhuvana Janmastema Bhangadi Leele. Leele. Okay, Leele, and I was going into that one. Bhagavan's sport, maybe it is inside to take some of these people to Moksham. But on the outward, it shows is a Leela. Desigan's view is to take all of them. Imperumanar says this one, I was telling Sandhyavandanam. Sandhyavandanam is the minimal thing you have to do. It gives the argadai, it gives you the yogyadai, it gives you the eligibility for you to do all other Vaidika karyams. To do Thiruvaradhanam.
Rent for the Sariram.
Correct. Correct. It is the rent what you pay for the Sariram. If you don't pay the rent, your body is not. You are not a Brahmanan anymore. If you miss the three parts of Sandhyavandanam, you have to be put another Ubanayam, re-Ubanayam. That is what they call. Okay. So Sandhyavandanam is a very, very important. All our Acharyas, they stress that one. All of them. So especially Nitya Naimitya Karmakal. Because Agyachedi Mamadrohi. So Bhagavan says that Agyached, these are all my commands. If you don't do, you are my drohi. Very tough word Bhagavan uses that one. So at least
Are they paying the rent for the
Dharmapatnis too? Dharmapatnis ke Rama, correct. See, Sri Dharmam is a little different. In a way, the way Mukura Singer and everything, everybody teaches on this one, if the guy does not do Sandhyavandanam, it's your problem. You try to influence him to go to the movie, to do the sari, to get all those things. Why don't you do this one? Sri Dharmam is, woman has to be good at home, at least on the religious part. Only then the male will get it automatically. So you have to influence him. So he says more of the Sandhyavandanam. Aradhanam is also there, part of that one. But if you cannot do Aradhanam, all other kinds of things, you do Dvaya Mantram, you listen to some of them, you do social service, you do Bhagavata Kaingaryam, you do temple Kaingaryam, so many things you can do. But Sandhyavandanam, there is no exception. I told you Sandhyavandanam. The Acharya who taught me, he was saying, even this guy was ready to do the samskaram for his own parents. He has to go take shower, do madhyanigam, and then only you do. Very, very important, Sandhyavandana. Very, very few places Sandhyavandana misses the time. Just like day before yesterday, Grahanam. When the Grahanam comes, Titundurdu. So you have to finish the Grahanam, take shava, then only Nitya Karma you have to do. So very, very rarely. Same thing if you are taking a Nambile and Nanjiyar was asking Parasara Bhattar when you are carrying the Perumal, going for Utsavam, Perumal, Elabandacha. So evening Atana, evening Anana, Perumal Dragachi, evening Sandhyavandanam only second. So you have to finish that and then they only do that one. So very few places they give you exception, but you can. They are not saying you forfeit that one. No, you don't have to do. You can do it late, delay. So, the first Mangala slogan, that one, Vinada Vivida Bhudavrada Rakshayga Dikshe. Rakshayga Dikshe. That is a key word. Key word. Embarumanar Rakshayga Dikshe. Why he takes that one? Because he is so much in love with Ramar. Ramar. Ramacharva slogam, that is what it reflects. Okay. Sagadeva prabannaya tavasmiti chayate abhayam sarvabhudebhyo abhayam. Okay. So, Embarumana loves Ramayanam so much. Okay. See, Krishna avataram is there, Rama avataram is there. Both of them are equally good. When you say one you like, one you better than the other, is for rasana only. But Ramavataram, what it does, most of them, they say, this is how you have to do. Like Srikanth was telling, did you do the backup of all your videos on YouTube? I said, no, I didn't do that one. They said somebody found out a method to wipe out the whole YouTube. And they put that one on YouTube. So you're telling, this is how you should not steal. This is how you should not steal. I never knew that method. Now only I'm learning. So Krishna's method is like that. Rama's method is not like that. Positive reinforcing. Okay. So he keeps on saying, Anuvulya Sangalpam. So that is why we always take Rama in that one. Do this way, do this way. Forget about bad. We don't have to know all of them. Say Rama shows everything, follow him. So, Vinada Vivida Bhudavrata Rakshayga Dikshe. If you go and surrender to Perumal, Perumal says, I'm going to give you the Rakshakam. Rakshakam not necessarily don't feel. Rakshakam means for the body. Atma, okay? Body is also there, but it's that is peanuts compared to the Atma. Shruti Shirasi Vidipte Brahmane Srinivase. We are going only high level meaning here. When we go inside also, we'll parse each one of them and go. Shruti Shirasi Vidipte. What do you see at the top of the Shruti? Brahmane Srinivase. Brahmanye. That is what Gajendra Moksham, Gajendra says. I told you, Paresaya, Paraisan. You didn't get it. Now I'm using the 2x4. Brahmanye. Now you know that one. Who am I calling? Brahmanye. Because Gajendra Stuti, 28 slogas, there is no Narayanan, no Govindan, no Madhusudanan, no Trivikraman. Okay? So, the Brahmanye, he says, Brahmani Srinivase. So, in Brahman are also very, very beautifully they put this word Srinivase. Srinivasan. When you say like that one, Sriyapadi Narayanan. And also is Trivengada Mudiyan. Why? Because all ancestors showed only Sharanagadi to Trivengada Mudiyan. Agalagalli nirayum endra alanmel mangai urai marva. Nammalvar, whatever you love, Ranganatha, your bhogam. But Srinivasan will give me the moksha. So all of them did Sharanagadi only. Why they did? We don't know. They love that one more. Because it looks like he's so majestic. Ranganath looks old. When I tell you, he may ask once more, Purana Purushaha. Okay? So, and you told that Saranagadi you do only once. What happens if you cannot hear? So that, I'm just joking. That is why they went to the Tirupati Perumal.
They feel comforted because Thayar's name is there.
Thayar's name is already there with him. Okay? Srinivasan. The Sri is not Adaimuri. It's not adjective. Sri is Sriyaha. Sri Stuti. Srihi Stuti. Not Sri means Tiru, something Shrestham. No, it is not. It is about Sri. Sri Gunaratna Gosham. Don't say Gunaratna Gosham. Sri Gunaratna Gosham. It is about all the gunas of Sri. Sri means. So everybody thought that's so great. Everybody tried to put that Sri there. So you have to distinguish who is the real Sri, where it is basically for wealthy kind of a thing. Mariyadi. Okay. So Srinivase, it could be both of them. Bhavadu mama parasmin semushi bhakti rubha. Very important this one. The reason I give you at a high level right now, Vedas says you go to moksham only because of jnanam. Because jivan's swarupam is jnanam. Only by jnanam you can go. Not necessarily so. That is what Emperumanar says. What jnanam it is important. The jnanam is bhakti rubhena jnanam. That jnanam has to manifest into bhakti. Okay? Remember Ragasetra Saram. Go back. Prabhatti. I have it in my head, sir. He is a seshi.
Seshan.
I am seshan. I am a servant for him. So this knowledge in the head, that is good enough. No, it is not good. It has to go to the anushthanam. So you have to go and do prabhatti. And the shadanga pananun desi and vichirgar. Why there is a shadanga is there? What you do, what you are specifically telling, which you are not doing that openly, explicitly in the samasranam. Atma samarpanam. Atma samarpanam. Angi. Thiridiya porulai thiripi kodukram. Whatever the stolen property I am giving, go back to Nyasa Dasakam. Okay, so that is very important. That is not explicit there. That is why Desigan says, yes, you say, sir, I made a mistake. I will not steal anything. I'll be a good boy. Sal, okay, man. Leave the product what you stole first. Put the product here. That is what he is asking. So without that, there's nothing. You can take and run away. You'll do it again. So you have to realize this Atma doesn't belong to you. You go and give it back to him. So that is Atma Samarpanam. Okay. So here. Oh, start.
No, there's nothing.
Oh, some message. Oh, Amma. Tomorrow is Swati?
Swati.
the remainder comes to tomorrow is Swadhi. Okay. Bhavadu mama parasmin semushi bhaktiruba. Bhagavan, the jnanam what you are giving, jnanam is not good. Jnanam could be, what are the many times, could be very stiff. Okay. Jnanam could be very stiff. Bhakti is the one bending. We understand. Namalvar says, showing that one in the Tamrabharani, when there's a floods are coming, huge trees, they're all falling down. Small grass, it's all bending and it's staying there. That is the definition of adiyen. Okay? That is the definition of adiyen. Nothing will take you. So if you start bending, dasan, adiyen, I am your servant. When you bend like that one, there is no problem. So, bhavad mama parasmin semushi bhakti rupa, Bhagavan, put me into bhakti all the time thinking about your lotus feet. So, very simplistically, he has written over here. This may look very similar to Kulasekhara Azhvar. Kulasekhara Azhvar asking the same bhakti also in all of them. Yathana janma adathalam, Krishna, I want only you. Your smaranai. I don't want anything else. So, Embarumana did not go at that level saying how many janmas. He says, Bhagavan, I want to do. I will be thinking only, see, when they had a new 747 for President George Bush, and they are asking, three new plane, huge plane came. Did you realize? I don't know. I went and slept. I don't know, it moved and it took off. I never realized when they take off. That is what we would be. We would never realize they take off. You are enjoying Perumal here. You will be enjoying Perumal there. When there is a location change, you will not see that. That is how we should be. True Prabhannas, it doesn't make any difference. What Desigan says, Prabhatyana Anantarame Moksham. What is stopping you? Your Abhyudha Prarabdha Karma. That is why you are not enjoying. Okay? So, we have to pray to Perumal. Despite of this Abhyudha Prarabdha Karma, Bhagavan, that's okay. Let me suffer some of them bodily, but you never let me go away from you. The thing what you have to ask Perumal is not on the worldly things, Vishayanubhavam, but more and more doing for Perumal. At that, definitely he will give. Because that he guaranteed to give you. So that's the first Mangala slogan over there. So let me do a couple of things and stop. Start thinking about that one. He starts with Agila Bhavana Janmasthema. Akila. Again, when you look at Ja, Agila Bhavana. Why you put a Bhavana? Because Puigayarvar start, Vayam Dagaliya Vargadale Nayaga, first word in Divya Prabandham. Mm-hmm. To give that one. But Puigayarvar can say all of them because Alvars, they enjoy the Perumal. They are not writing it for you. They enjoy the Perumal. It was overflowing. We went and caught that. But Acharyas, they do it for you. So it has to be like a legal book. That is why they put all of them. So, Agila means Agharam. Agar artho Vishnugu. Agar mudala eluthellam. Adi Bhagavan mudetre ulagi. Everything is Agharam. Aksharanam Akharosmi. Krishna says. That is what Parashara Bhattar goes and asks his father, Kurathalvan. He could have written Nikila. Nothing with everything is including. Sagala. He didn't write that. Why did he do Agila? So Kurathalvan explains that why it is. Akila means Agharam. Agara means Narayana. The first word, first letter, enough. If you understand that, you don't need Sribharsham. So Agharam means Agararto Rakshagan. So we'll see the Agarartham what we saw in that one. Rakshagan. Agara, Ugara, Magara, Idi. We broke all of them. He's a Rakshagan. So Rakshagatvam. That is why Srinivase, Brahmani, Srinivase, Rakshagam. What is the Rakshagam you are asking? Atma. Atma should be thinking about you, nothing else. So, Pogiyarvar started. That's what I said. Amalanadi Biran also, Arvara started with Akaram. That is why it is. So, and also, the next one I says, Agila Bhavana Janmasthema Bhangadi Lele. First Adhyayam. Samanvayadhyayam. Samanvayadhyayam. Each adhyayam has got four padams. Four adhyayams. This is from Brahma Sutra. Four adhyayams, four padams, 16. Out of 16, the first one you take, Samanvayam. What he says, Samanvaya means harmony. Everything comes and connects only to Narayana. Hey, you told Sat, Achit, Hiranyagarbhan, Brahma, Ishwaran, Narayanan. It tells everything is Parabrahman. It is so confusing. That is what Vedas are. Hey, they tell all of them. So you tell, one day you call sweetheart, one day you call something, one day you call. But why do you say all of them? Here you say so high, here you say so low. How come it all refer to one guy? Because his actions are like that. That is why we call them differently. Because his manifestation over there, that is why we call them. He is the indweller. That is Sisare Ragasasa. So when we say Hiranyagarbhan, when we say Shivan, when you say Agni, when you say Vayu, when you say Varunan, when you say Indran, we don't refer him. There's something else inside. That is what we are referring. So I told you, when we say a person, it may refer to the body, it may refer to the Atma, it may refer to both of them. Sripriya come here means it's both. Sripriya is 6 feet tall means it's body. Sripriya is a Punyasali means it's the Atma. So you should be able to. In Srivashyam, what we, the first thing we learn, everything is context sensitive. Write it down, context sensitive. So don't take one part. Tattumasi Vyakhyanam, very, very important. That's where we're going to see. So how do you explain with respect to the total thing? Don't take, you took words and misinterpreted, right? So part of the sentence, all the politicians say, that's what exactly. You cannot take something and interpret differently. So, Agila Bhavana Janmastema Bangadi Lile. First, how beautifully explains in Tamil, Brahmam Jagat Karaname. Brahmam is the Jagat Karanam. What is the duty? What is the job for Brahmam? Jagat Karanam. In the second one, Vinada Vivida Bhudavrada Rakshaga Dikshe. So he gives Rakshagam, means the third and fourth chapters. We come here. Because he gives Rakshagam, and the Rakshagam means you do Kaingaryam for him. Shrudisirasi Vidipte Brahmani Srinivase. Shrudisirasi Vidipte Brahmani Srinivase. All the Upanishads talks only Narayanan. Mudaldala enna sonnom? When you look here, Narayanan Jagat Karaname. Narayanane Jagat Karanam. Second. What it means, he is the one and only. See, when we say Narayanan Jagat Karanam mean, he will do. But on Saturday and Sunday, he may not be there. Somebody else would be doing. It is not. Narayanan Oruvane. So the rule says, number one rule, I am the boss. Number two, if you have any questions, go back to rule number one. That is what he says. Exactly. So, Samanvaya Adhyayam. Second, Avirodha Adhyayam. Virodham, Avirodham. Non-conflict. And then third one is basically the Sadhana Adhyayam and then Phala Adhyayam. Okay, maybe we'll stop here. And Desigan says, Tattva Tigai. So beautifully comes, explains. Semushi Bhakti Rupa. Let me explain. What is Semushi Bhakti Rupa? Desigan explains in Tattva Tika. We take here and there a lot of what our acharyas have done to explain these things much better. They have done all of them. We cannot do all of them. So if you look at that one, Deshika has done amazing. Adhigana Saravali, we will take that one. Only very few. 16 padam, 16 phrases. Single slogan. You will memorize that one. Single slogan. 16 phrases of that one. All the 16 padams of Brahma Sutram. If you go into Meivirdhanyam, 16 lines he wrote in Tamil, all of them. That also we will see. So we'll get in connection with all of them. So, Kavidharkiga Simmaya Kalyana Gunasarini, Srimade Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha, Srimade Nikamanta Maha Deshikaya Namaha.